Good, you're back. I'm Neom, and today's episode is about dominant genes. Please bear in mind that, compared to most geneticists, I'm lacking about 12 years of gene school and at least 10 years of experience in working with genetics. I'm just conducting the same research that any reasonably curious person would conduct and telling you what I've found. If you enjoy, leave a like. If you want to see more content, subscribe for more content by clicking the subscribe button below. Let's get into it. First, a tiny lecture in the function of genes and alleles. To begin with, when people talk about a dominant trait, such as brown eyes, they're referring to the function of the allele, not the gene, as the video title suggests. A gene refers to the trait itself. An example of this would be having hair. The fact that you have hair at all is the gene's fault. The allele is the variation of that gene. So brown, black, blonde, most of us have that gene. It's like if we all brought a lovely bundt cake to the party, but yours had lemon zest and mine had orange zest. Same dish, different ingredients. Alleles make up the gene. So the next time someone says brown eyes are a dominant gene, you can say, ha! It's actually a dominant allele. Nerd. So what are some of those dominant traits? Tongue rolling, believe it or not, is the result of a dominant trait. Of course, we all have the same muscles in our tongue, so this ability can be learned even if you aren't born with the allele to do it in the first place. But having this trait means that you can do it without having to learn. You might do it as a baby before ever seeing someone else do it. Dimples are a dominant trait too. This one can't be learned, but it can probably be achieved through mammoth quantities of money and some plastic surgery. Right-handedness is a dominant trait. No, there's not one specific gene that contains one specific allele that makes you right-handed. You can't just go do some gene splicing and all of a sudden you're a lefty. This is the result of nearly 100 different alleles, all with some minor effects, that result in your being either right or left-handed. Because most of those alleles lead to a person being right-handed, only 5 to 10% of the world is left-handed. Similar to that, but not directly related, is hand clasping. About 55% of people clasp their hands with their left thumb on top, as you're no doubt trying right now. Which one were you? Let me know in the comments. If you have broad lips, chances are that your kids will too. Have a white streak in your hair? You're probably related to Cruella de Vil, and she's passed that dominant trait all the way down to you. The craziest one to me, though, is another hand-related one. Having 5 fingers on each hand is a recessive trait. The dominant trait is having 6 fingers on each hand. So if you or a loved one have been diagnosed with 6 fingers, odds are that your kids will also have 6 fingers. This trait is called polydactyl. That word doesn't refer specifically to the number 6, it just means supernumerary digits, and is more common among animals, like cats. Why then, you ask, doesn't everyone have 6 fingers on each hand? Wouldn't their 12-fingeredness eventually reach across the whole of Earth's population? Well, to be honest, I couldn't find an answer, at least not one that I could comprehend based on my limited arsenal of hand-centric vocabulary. But I do know that the story that it's because of all the 6-fingered people being killed in the medieval ages because people thought they were witches is false. But the best answer I can come up with is that people are creeped out by 6-fingered-itis and aren't willing to have babies with Mr. Dodecahands over here. But hey, maybe I'm wrong and someday they'll take over the planet and these AI art generators are just predicting the future. Some other examples of dominant traits are detached earlobes, long eyelashes, and mid-digital hair. I thought that one was going to be some crazy glowing cyberpunk LED hair, but what it really means is having hair on your middle digit. Widow's peaks, freckles, and high blood pressure are also examples of dominant traits. So is a Roman nose, which is the trait of having that bump in the bridge of your nose like I have, the one that looks like a beluga whale surfacing the crest of a wave. Why don't you think I ever show you my face in full profile? If you enjoyed this video, leave a like, subscribe for more content, ring the bell to be notified about new videos, and comment what you want to learn about next. I'm Neom, and I'll see you next time.